Did you know there are only three aquaria, which is the plural for aquarium, just learnt that, left in New Zealand. Three aquaria in New Zealand, and now one of them is on the verge of being shut down.
Yeah, EcoWorld in Picton has been running for 20 years, but the lease, it's expired. It's expiring tonight, in fact, at midnight. A feud between the aquarium and the port is the hottest topic in Picton right now. So, naturally, Julian Lee wanted to take a look inside.
Aquaria are full of curiosities. But the South Island's only aquarium is itself a most curious place.
This one's a cook straight to a tara.
It's incredibly soft, isn't it?
Very, yeah, it's very much unexpected. Much softer than you'd expect.
Got one that's about 160, so it takes a couple
160
of,
years old.
I think he's still a bit of a spring chicken too.
He's hibernating at the moment, so he's sleeping through the winter. He has been in that exact position for the last 6 weeks or so.
You've got a rabbit?
We have a few rabbits, yes.
If we give him a little bit of a pat on the back here, what he's going to do is peel back.
Oh.
And he's going to show us his shell.
It's like a reverse power.
This is a grey side guild sea slug.
A million people have been through here over the years.
Someone went out for a dive, caught a crayfish for dinner, took it home, and the wife looked at his little face and she said, no, I'm not eating that. He's going to the aquarium.
Can he puff?
He has puffed once, but it's actually really, really bad for them to puff.
Oh, really?
We've got the Picton cinemas here as well, so we're an aquarium, we're also a movie theatre.
So this is actually our biggest cinema that we've got. It seats 33.
You've got other ones?
Yeah, I'll show you. I can show you some of the other ones. Some days, yeah, you've got the cinema, you've got the fish, you've got, like right now, we've got all of this extra stuff going on, so my brain's just... It's a lot to take in.
A lifelong dream for the ex-stockbroker.
Wanted to be Gerald Darrell or Dave Attenborough, man.
Really?
Yeah, oh God, yeah.
Then, one day, a hand-delivered envelope from landowner Port Marlborough.
All along, we've always been the assumption, we've always been led to believe that, yes, your lease is going to be renewed.
For me, this was very, very sudden. For John, this was very, very sudden.
The bare minimum 3 months to say, clear out your building, dispose of your animals, and for $75,000, we'll take your building off you.
We're not a boat shed, we're not a retail store. We've got live animals here that rely on us to keep them safe and meet their needs.
The lease ends at midnight tonight. The port says they discussed extending the lease with EcoWorld, but EcoWorld didn't accept the terms.
What will happen to the animals?
They can't be released. They can't fend for themselves, they can't feed themselves, they can't defend themselves. It's like opening up the doors of a rest home and opening the door, they step outside and the first thing a bus hits them because someone's got a bit of dementia. They didn't know a bus existed. Well, that's what will happen there. They'll be dead in a day.
Move them to another aquarium up north? John says they wouldn't survive the journey. In fact, he reckons there's only one option. Mass euthanasia.
This whole slaughter the animals thing's got a little bit out of hand because there's no way I'm ever gonna, these guys will be rehomed.
Janelle may be right. After all, the Department of Conservation is quietly on the case. But in the meantime, EcoWorld has less than 5 hours left to get off the hook. Unless, of course, there is a sea change on the horizon.